council's cash that is held until such time that it's needed and paid out to meet financial obligations. It's not slowly investing money with the intention of generating income. This report provides a Treasury management strategy statement on likely financing and investment activity for ahead of the next financial year. It fulfills a requirement prescribed by the Code of Practice on Treasury Management. The strategy sets guidelines in respect of counterparties we may invest with during the year ahead, along with detailing our expected borrowing strategy. Treasury Management performance indicators are also produced for 2020-21. Appendix G of the strategy also provides a list of council officers who are granted authorised signatory status by shareholders in respect of Treasury Management activities. Along with setting a strategy to Treasury activity to 2021, summary position as at 31st of December is given as per. The balance of investments at 31st December 2019 was £33 million. The majority of our Treasury investment activities 2019-2020 has been in the money market funds. We currently have no outstanding investments with other local authorities. The level of outstanding longer-term borrowing has continued to fall in 2019-20. The balance was £173 million at the 31st December 2019. This reduction has resulted in lower interest costs for the council and revenue budget savings that have contributed to the overall outturn for a number of years. We've utilised the interlocal authority loan market to aid cash flow requirements and short-term financing of the capital programme. As at the 31st of December, we had £105 million borrowed from other local authorities on short-term, low-interest loans. Our approach is in line with a consistent trend for inter-local authority lending, which in recent years has increased as authorities look to minimise their borrowing costs. Can I move straight to the recommendations in this report? In recent years, local authorities have had an increasing focus on commercial activities, including but not exclusively to property. Such activity has the potential to bring both increased returns and increased positive and negative risk. In February 2018, the Ministry for Housing, Communities and Local Government published updated guidance on local government investments. The revised guidance requires that a separate investment strategy focusing on non-treasury investments is produced and approved annually by Council. This report fulfills that requirement. The new report notes key considerations when assessing potential commercial investments, including contributions to the Council from the investment, the level of security of the investment, risk assessment of the loss of investments, the liquidity of the investment, that is how quickly Council can withdraw its investment. I'd just like to point out there's a slight error in later on in the report, at page 219, 3.1, where the office or is no longer a commercial investment and will be going forward, so just need to that. If no one objects, we can find like to read the recommendations in this report.
Chris, when the man here is such a social care, particularly this disorder, greater pressure than on frontline services every day. And you know, in contrast, we heard about the funding review. In contrast, we looked at a couple of figures. Hampshire Council and Leafy South is set to receive a budget increase of £35.3 million for a 14.23% rise in its budget. That's going to be unfair. And the third funding review, of course, will affect, as I said, our funding is allocated and redistributed between local authorities from 2020 onwards. And that's been exposed, has it not? There's certainly indications to date suggest we're going to lose an awful lot here on top of all that other money that's going to be asked from our budget. I don't know how we're going to tell them, how councils are going to tell them. You know, because it's going to decimate budgets, I would suggest, more than we've seen in previous years. And the review, of course, will also see £300 million of funding from less, and this is fact, read up on it, less affluent Labour councils to areas that are Conservative controlled. And if that's not partisan, I don't know what is. I know that despite having one out and one out slightly out of our backs, we as Labour Council, you know, as the minority administration, continue to, in effect, do we not make world safer and protect and support the most vulnerable in our society. But the cuts will have consequences. As I say, they are politically partisan. If you look at it, they are partisan. These cuts will be made. And the levels of inequality come with them. The 10 most deprived local authorities in England will face a 13% cut on average, while the wealthiest will see their budgets grow on average by 13%, just like that one I said in Hampshire. Funding for social care, we heard from Councillor Jones, for older people is due to drop in the northwest, but the southeast and southwest will see an increase. If that's not partisan, I don't know what is. The changes flow from new formula, as we heard earlier from Stuart, that will dramatically reduce the importance of deprivation when calculating funding allocation, should I say. Today, to speak, the council's reserves, of course, as we heard, Councillor Williamson had done those for a decade, and we've forced to rely on them to bridge the gaps in our funding. So, you know, it is an awful situation where, and as I said earlier, if the other parties on this council truly believe that they're doing the best for all the people they represent, and I do believe they believe that, well, I do call upon them again to join us in lobbying the Conservative government to get the best deal we can from the Wirral. I'll just finish on that. And again, can I thank members, and particularly can I thank Councillor Jeff Williamson. She